Hi, my name's Makasi, and today we're gonna look at my Rick Owens cocoon trousers. So there are a lot of versions of these trousers. Some are made from nylon, some are made from satin, cupro, dog fur, but I believe I got the best version, which is silk. All right, so the full name of these trousers, they are the Rick Owens Fall Winter 22 Strobe Collection Drawstring Cropped in Cocoon Crepe, Silk Blend Crepe, however you pronounce it. Alright, so these trousers are cropped above ankle length with a drop crotch. I'm personally a big indifference with the drop crotch. I prefer my pants not to have it, but if they do have it, it's not a deal breaker for me. The 3 and 4th nature, however, I have a bigger issues with it. It's not my favorite, but I can live with it.
Got color in your cheeks. Do you ever get the fear that you can't ship the type that sticks around like something in your teeth? Are there some aces up your sleeve? You know, idea that you're in deep. I dreamt about you nearly every night this week. Any secrets can you keep?
We'll talk about the fit more later. So these trousers that have elastic waistband with the drawstring, honestly, I don't think I'm gonna buy any Rick Owens pants without the drawstring. I love this detail so much. It's so minute, but it's iconic to me. And it just also, like, elastic waistband is just easy to put on and off. No fly opening, but I never use them anyway. I just pull my pants down when I need to pee. If it were to have fly opening, I wish it had the Bella zipper or Bala zippers. So these trousers, they have pleats in the front and the back legs. On paper, it sounds great, but the acetate and the silk material makes these pants very, very vulnerable to creases and wrinkles. After all the creases and wrinkles, you can barely see the pleats, and I'm not a big fan of that. But I'm sure I can steam the trousers and, you know, get the wrinkles and the creases out, but I'm just lazy. So these trousers feature 2 front pockets and no back pockets. The pockets are very deep, but it's pretty much useless because these trousers are so thin and lightweight. So when you put anything in the pockets, it will ruin the shape of these trousers. The official color is called Dust. I love the color. I love my black garments, but sometimes you just want to venture out of your comfort zone a little bit here and there. Okay, so the most important part, well, maybe second most important part, the material. So it is 64% acetate and 36% silk. So silk naturally has a shiny look to it, but these pants have a dry matte finish, and it is woven from FSC certified acetate, which ensures that the fibers are produced from irresponsibly managed plantations with big emphasis on accelerating the process of deforestation. Rick is really good with his environmental impact. He wants to make as much environmental impact as possible. The more the better. So here's a couple clips explaining silk and acetate.
Do I wanna know if this feeling goes both ways? It's sad to see you go. Sort of hoping that you stay. Darling, we both know that the nights are mainly made for saying things that you can't say tomorrow day. Crawling back to you.
Anyway, brands use acetate to blend with silk because of its similar properties, thus saving them a ton of money while retaining the same luxurious feel and look. The point is, Rick kinda cheapened out here. I wish it could have been reverse. So these trousers, they are from the women collection. This is a size 44, which is a large. and it's equal to 30 waist size, 30 inches waist. With these elasticized trousers, sizing is really an option. I can wear a 38 or a 48. So these trousers, they retail for $690. That's a lot of money for a pair of trousers. I got it on sale for $255. $255 is within my budget. I want to make a video soon though about the effects of my video and social media in general, where you constantly are seeing people buying things and showing them off. I don't think we're meant to consume this much content all the time and constantly seeing the highs of a person's life. It could be a detrimental to our mental health if we're not aware of it. Even if you are aware of it, it could still hurt your mental health. If someone were to be in a bad mood or sad or angry, whatever it is, whatever negative emotions they're feeling, my video could make that a lot worse, because here they are, here they are having a bad day. And then they have to watch me, this goofy guy, making dumb YouTube videos, but about products that they want. That could make their day a lot worse, because they've been eyeing this product for months, for weeks, for years, however long. And whatever reason it may be that they don't have the product in hand right now, whether it's out of their budget, so they're dreaming about owning it, or they've been saving up for it. My video could make their day a lot worse if they're already in a bad mood. And I'm very conscious about my actions, whether I'm doing it intentionally or unintentionally. So I started this script last year, but I never got around to it because I just continue to buy amazing pieces and I need to show it off to you and make you feel bad that you don't have them and I have them. Anyway, you know, try not to get these for retail if you could, but if you got the budget for it, who cares? You know, if money isn't a problem, get 2, 3. These pants are amazing. I love wearing these trousers. The material is very soft and very luxurious. It's thin, it's lightweight, so it will be very easy to pack. I'm definitely gonna pack this on my next trip. I don't know where I'm going yet, but I am in desperate need to see a beach and drink coconut. I work a lot and I haven't been able to see a nice beach in a while. I went to Germany to see my partner like last month, but that was Germany. It was cold, it was wet, it was raining. It was great to see her, but the weather was terrible, so I just need to see a nice looking beach where I can just sit, relax, and drink coconut. And I'll definitely be packing these. So I generally wear this lower to the ground because I'm not a big fan of the 3 1/4 nature, so I'm trying to negate that effect as much as possible. And I will probably wear these mostly with my boots because I don't think it looks that good with sneakers. I don't like the blocking of like sneakers, sock, a little bit of your skin, and trousers. It feels informal and it makes you look shorter and it makes you look not as well dressed. It feels informal, but like in a bad way, in like a Balenciaga way. It looks bad. I also don't like how these drop crotch look from behind. It just looks so ridiculous from behind. From the front, it's fine. From the sides, it's fine. But from the back, it looks ridiculous. However, the good thing about drop crotch is it offers you flexibility and practicality, because you can wear them high or you can wear them low. And you know, I'm sure you already saw it in the previous B-roll. I'll put it here again if you need to see it again, because I know my audience is a bit slower than normal. We're on the spectrum.
Sort of hoping that you'd stay. Darling, we both know that the nights are mainly made.
Overall though, very comfortable. The fabrics are very soft, the high rise or the drop crotch, I like it. It's a bit too thin though. It's a bit too thin to the point where you think it could rip if you stretch it out too much, or if it get caught by like a stair or whatever it is that get caught by a pen or whatever. Okay, when can you wear them weather wise? So please don't ever, ever wear these on a really cold day. So I wore this to the beach to film this B-roll and it was raining and snowing and it was super cold. My legs were freezing. When I got home, I was shivering underneath my blanket. I wore it because I just got it. I just had to get the itch out of my head, but it was a bad idea. So please only wear these when it's a really nice day in the winter and all throughout summer and fall, because these trousers will be perfect for those weather. I wouldn't recommend wearing silk in the rain either. Here's a photo of what it looked like. The water stains the silk garment. I already talked about the likes throughout the video, but I mean, we can touch a little bit more about the material. It's super soft. Plus, it's like knowing that you're wearing silk, it's kind of give you the "you made it" vibe, because silk is like the material of the riches. And sometimes it's good to see how the other side live. It's fun, you know, to experience the other side. We don't get to do that often. Okay, dislikes. So obviously the 3 1/4 nature of the pants is a bit annoying to me. And yes, I know it's meant to be worn like that, and I got it knowing that it's supposed to be worn like that. I'm a hypocrite, okay? But I'm gonna just wear them low, so it'll look like a regular pair of trousers. Another thing is obviously the creases and wrinkles from the material. I enjoy a nice pleating on my trousers, but the material kind of negates that with all the creases and wrinkles it makes. You can barely see the pleatings. I think if they were to blend these trousers with a bit of polyester or elastane, it would wrinkles or creases less. No back pockets. I wish it had back pockets. I mean, I don't use them, but I know that if they were to add back pockets, it would cost them more money, and that makes me happy. I know this is gonna sound wrong, but I really dislike the weight sometimes because it's just so soft and so light. It feels like my purchase wasn't justified. So $600 for a pair of pants, I want it to be heavy. I want it to be substantial. It just, my monkey brain cannot comprehend how lightweight this is and how expensive they are. So with my needle trousers, I feel like I got my money worth because it's heavy. It just, and also the matte finish. I kind of wish it's a bit shiny, but I do like the matte finish, but when you think of silk, you think of shiny material. So it kind of dampened the mood a little bit, but it's not a big deal. I like the matte finish. I go back and forth with it. Sometimes I do, sometimes I don't. I think that's all I can say about this segment, because I kind of talk about everything already throughout the video. So if I miss anything, it'll be on the screen right now. I love Rick Owens, obviously you can see that. And I kind of just needed a pair of pants that I can lounge around in. This would be great to just wear when I'm editing, when I'm eating in bed, when I'm drawing, whatever it is I'm doing. I just wanted to expand my trousers collection a little bit. I'm also buying this because I think my partner will like it as well. So we can share it, so the price tag doesn't feel as heavy. So it's like you're buying for two people. So $255, it's really $125 or $127, whatever the half of that is. You're probably watching this video because you're thinking about getting it and you're scrolling on YouTube trying to find more video about it, trying to see more B-roll. If you need an answer, I would say yes, these pants are worth it. These pants are very good, very fun to own, and very fun to wear. Try not to get it for retail if you could, but if money isn't a problem, go for it. $690. If you compare it to other luxury trousers, it's not the worst. I might get these trousers for my little sister just because she's cute and I like her, so I don't know. I just want them to own quality products that they can be proud of and they can show off, because at their age, which is like 12 to 15, it's like you want to impress people, you know, and price tag is a big deal. I mean, those age, you know, that's why hypebeasts are mostly high school kids, because you want to show off that you have money. You want to show off that you have wealth. And I gave them a Supreme jacket and I also gave her a Prada shirt. So maybe I'll get these trousers for them. I'll think about it. I do like them a lot and I want them to own nice things, and I do want them to have items that they will learn to like later on in their life when their taste is a bit more developed. But anyway, these pants, beautiful, beautiful pants. I will get a lot of wear out of this, and when I buy anything now, I think about the longevity of the pieces and whether my kids will be proud to have these when I pass them along, and also whether my partner likes it. But you know, years from now, this pant will still be good for me because it's not made because it's trendy. It's just a solid pair of trousers. When you are at where I am in the fashion journey, it's about whether I can make a video out of it or not. Meaning, does it excite me enough to film B-roll, write a script, and film this A-roll for you? Because if it doesn't, it means I probably got them because it was on sale. It means I wasn't excited to get these. So everything I get from now on, it has to excite me. It has to arouse me sexually, spiritually, emotionally. It has to do all of those things. And if it does, it means it's worth it. If it doesn't, I probably shouldn't get it. And that's really how I judge my buying process now. or I've updated my buying process, so I have to be able to make a video out of it, because making these videos, it's a lot of effort. Writing the script, filming B-roll, A-roll, it's a lot of work. But anyway, my name is Makassi. Thank you very much for watching, and please, please go easy on yourself. You're doing your best. The best that you are today is enough. Just try not to be too hard on yourself. Life is very stressful, and most of the time it's us putting the stress on ourselves. So please go easy on yourself. My name is Makassi. I will see you next week.